Flutter, flutter, my dearest butter. Butterflies are but a small, teensy-tiny part of this game. However, with enough knowledge, their roles grow tremendously. From automatic farms to never-ending quests for butter, and even some lunar connections. Let us talk butterflies. Butterflies spawn from flowers, even evil flowers, every 10 to 15 seconds. It's usually on the lower side. However, do note that only four can be fluttering about in a somewhat large area at any given time. But chances are you won't even notice that slight spawn constraint, because you'll be either catching or murdering the suckers. But before we discuss all that here, let us discuss more spawning notes. Because butterflies are only available during the day. Because as soon as dusk hits, they fly to the nearest flower and then take a snooze. Furthermore, come winter, not a single butterfly will be saying hello. So, be mindful there. But let us talk the bug net. It is a net for bugs. So if you wish to net bugs, craft a bug net. You have 10 uses per net, and the process of netting bugs should not be hard for you to understand. But while we can now choose to murder these defenseless creatures within our inventories, know that the alternative is using these butterflies to plant additional flowers wherever you please. This is great for setting up farms, of which we'll be discussing soon, but also for bee box areas to aid in honey production. Fantastic stuff. But let's say you are as heartless as me and have slaughtered the beasts. How do the wings stack up? Well, at 8 health and 9.375 hunger per wing, butterfly wings are actually pretty handy as a quick snack and healing, especially in the early game for newer players. But if you stay tuned, we will talk some easy farms that'll just have butterfly wings coming out of your ears. For now, however, know that these butterfly wings can be used to whip up butter muffins within our crockpots. Butter muffins restore 20 health, nearly 40 hunger, and 5 sanity each munch. And considering the recipe, these are stellar baked goods, so do keep them in mind. Butterfly wings are also used in straight up crafts as well. Like the Glossomer Saddle here. Now, you may look at this and say how egregious the necessary 68 butterfly wings actually are, and you'd be right. But nonetheless, expect a 55% movement speed increase for your beeflo for your trouble, if you go through all the trouble, that is. However, let us discuss some basic ways to amass the suckers. What you see before you is a farm as old and simple as they come. Catch butterflies, plant a crap ton of flowers, and simply wait for them to spawn in order to brutally end their life. You don't need the walls, however, the walls actually contain the fluttering beasts, so I would recommend them, actually. This option is very simple, yes, but not very efficient. Oh, and speed and control F are your friends here, and will make things a bit easier along the way. So the other option in my book is this. Just screw all the flowers and use just one. Find or create a location with only a single flower for miles, and you will not only know exactly where the butterflies will be showing themselves, making for a far easier time killing them, mind you. I just swear that the butterflies seem to spawn much faster than normal, which is totally bonkers, but whatever the case, wings galore at very, very little cost to you. And maybe, just maybe, you will start to get some butter along the way. Butterflies have a stellar 2% chance of dropping the totally not unhealthy stick of goodness. And by their lonesome, butter restores 40 health and 25 hunger each. Absolutely phenomenal. Note too, it takes a long time for them to spoil, which should be used to your advantage. Butter can be used in a number of recipes as a substitute for dairy. However, there are some that require the stuff in full. Like Waffles here. These delicious stacks of unhealthy deliciousness restore 60 health, 37.5 hunger, and 5 sanity, a sweet, sweet munch. Beautiful. And part of a not-so-balanced breakfast. Warly players can use butter, most any fruit, and honey to whip up another breakfast item, fresh fruit crepes. These puppies restore 60 health once more, however boast a 150 hunger gain, as well as the bonus 15 sanity. Pretty darn incredible on occasion. And finally, the newest butter-required recipe, lobster dinner. Toss some lobsters in with a stick of butter for 60 health, 37.5 hunger, and 50 sanity each meal. Honestly, pretty incredible considering how simple the recipe actually is. And 50 sanity matches the highest gain of any food in the entire game. But yes, although not technically required, we will toss in ice cream as well. Enjoy a whopping 0 health, 25 hunger, and 50 sanity, as well as lowering your temperature by 40 for 15 seconds upon having a scoop. And before we wrap up with lunar flies, let us discuss more efficient butterfly farming. A lot of folk swear by catcoon farming, and while it is one where you have to do literally nothing while they swat at the fluttering beast, usually missing though, which should be a factor, they also eat the dang wings. So really, this is more of a butter farm at the end of the day. Not only that, unless you get lucky with stump spawns, you will have to move some catcoons yourself, which just takes effort, so not my choice. And trust me, while there are others, I say cut the crap and keep it simple. Plant a flower or flowers around magma pools, and the butterflies will just straight up kill themselves for ya. I use the walls to once again contain the insects and even direct them toward said magma pools. And this right here is very likely the best butterfly farm out there. Wings for days with butter to boot now and then. So get to it and have fun making your own versions. However, to wrap it up, moon moths, the lunar island equivalent of a butterfly. They spawn from felled loon trees, and there's a 50% chance to have 2 spawn overall. And while they will die naturally in but 4 minutes, we can catch them all the same as the others. Moon moths themselves are needed to adopt the mothling from the rock den. And the mothling actually gives off light, so it is honestly probably the only useful pet in the entire game. Oh, and if you are worried about your moon moths starving before you get back to the den, you can actually feed them vegetables from within your inventory, which is kinda cool. And oh, times two, moon moths are also used to plant additional loon trees wherever you wish. So neat stuff. But to finish the day, moon moth wings. They restore the same amount of health, the same amount of hunger, and can even be used for butter muffins. However, these little guys also restore 15 sanity each. A lot for something that is not a crockpot dish. Not bad at all. Just one other mention would be that butterflies are considered non-hostile creatures. So yes, our naughtiness will increase when we are just straight up murdering them over and over and over again. But it is only 1 point per butterfly, so it's really not that great. But there you have it, everyone. Butterflies and their lunar counterpart, moon moths. I hope you saw how something so small could lead to bigger and better things overall. Thanks for watching, folks. Well wishes to all, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.